Hey everybody, it's Norm from Tested, and for today's show and tell, I want to talk to you about action figures, and specifically about one feature of action figures that, and figures in general, that are really important for collectors and for toy photographers, and that's points of articulation. I have here some figures from a new company based out of New York. They're called Art Bones, and they reach out to let me know that they're developing, these two designers, their own line of these 12th scale, 6-inch tall figures that they're not only designing from scratch, but they're manufacturing themselves using resin 3D printers in New York and doing small batch manufacturing, which really piqued my interest. And it gave me a chance to not only check them out, but let's talk about what can make these interesting and how these might compare to some of the figures when you're shopping around for posable figures to either take quick pictures of or just even to play with. So when I was buying figures like back in the 80s and 90s, even early 1000s. You know, I'd buy something at a toy store or buy something online, but I get it. The first thing I want to do is, you know, pose it in a certain way, find a way to display it on my shelf or take a picture of it. And something I always noticed is that no matter how much I move the figure around, the arms, the elbows, the legs, and all the accessories around, sometimes the poses never felt really natural. And that's because that toys made of plastic or metal or whatever they're made of, they don't always have the same type of mobility, the points of articulation that a human naturally would. We have so much, we're very dexterous creatures, from our fingers to our elbows. Like, we can contort our bodies in all sorts of different ways. And even when we're just standing still or holding a resting pose, you know, that's very different leaning one way than the other way. And so for a figure to have all those points of articulation requires a lot of engineering. And that's why people look for things like, you know, double hinge joints on the legs or on the elbows. You can actually bend the legs. Well, the folks at Art Bones, they told me they designed the armature, the skeleton underneath their figure from scratch. And they actually will send me one of these here. That lets me show you exactly what we're talking about when we're talking about articulation. Now, there are a couple different types of basic joints that you might find in a figure. There's your, you know, ball and socket joint, which you might find right here on the elbow. In fact, there's like a, I think this is called a dumbbell joint, where you have two ball and sockets that allows not only for you to move your arm here, but in two places, so you can actually get the arm to wrap around the front of your chest. Same with the elbow. Here you have a double hinge joint. If it was a single hinge joint, you can bend just in this one axis, but the fact that it's a double hinge joint, you can then fold that forearm all the way around and do something that looks much more natural. Now, of course, our bodies don't have two hinges at the elbow, but we can still bend here because we're not made of plastic. We're flesh, and we can compress our muscles. There are no muscles here to compress. It's just that plastic. You also have things like pivot joints on the bottom, swivel joints here. So it's a combination like swivel and hinge at your feet. And then, of course, things like a torso, an ab crunch is a very important thing as well, which is kind of like a hinge joint. And the way they do their ab crunch on this figure is really interesting, because not only does it let you compress here, you can actually pull up, get a little bit of travel here, which then allows for a bigger compression. Yeah. With all these joints combined, this figure has 37 points of articulation. Allows a pretty good amount of flexibility. So this is fascinating, and I love that this was all designed not only in their studio, but it was also manufactured in their studio as well. These are all 3D printed pieces. There's no injection molded tooling that they made. They're making this on demand as people order these. And something to help with the durability of this, they told me, is this idea of having this rubber O-ring. You see that black ring right there along these joints, that's where the points of contact are, so you're not constantly rubbing that resin off and having the pieces pop off. And because they're doing these basically made to order, and because they're doing all the design in-house, they have a ton of variety of faces, of hands that they can ship with these. But on top of this armature, of course, different variants. They have this exposed muscle version, which I really love, with a bunch of different heads, you know, swappable hands, and I'm having so much fun just posing these figures, of like looking at almost like yoga poses and figuring out how much can I contort this figurine, it's something I was never, ever able to do with the toys I had growing up, or even some of the high-end toys I'm paying for and buying off the shelf right now. This is just really, really impressive. The one thing I do wish it had was, I wish it had maybe some more cut joints here, where, like, for example, some toys you might be able to twist as a cut line on the thigh or on the upper arm, where you can actually turn here. You have a little bit of that right here. And also the tips of the toes. Sometimes you have a hinge joint also on the toes that allow you to stand on tippy toes. That's something that they didn't design into at least the first version of these figures. But it is, you know, talking to some of the toy photographers that we've met, it is something that's hugely important to them. The posability, the points of articulation, type of engineering that's required. And I love that this Art Bones figure allows me to really appreciate all of that. As toys get more complicated, as the technology that allows for enthusiasts, collectors to design their own toys becomes possible as well. If you are someone who takes photos of toys or have had great experience with some figure lines that have great posability and lots of points of articulation, I'd love to know about them in the comments below. But I'm gonna spend the rest of this video doing some more posing.